It's interesting to listen to the origins of Slumcode and to learn and understand that Albert is here at Strathmore as well. But there's one thing in your presentation you said, and you say that even today, some of your colleagues are not here because they don't believe this is about them, this is the place for them. And I just want to spend 2 minutes just on that, and I'll sit down, because that is the essence of Vision 2030. In fact, you should tell your colleagues that they are not alone in that sense of not belonging, or in that sense of feeling and thinking and having internalized that their role or their place in society is way down there. Actually, it's a national problem. When I make presentations, the other day I was in Washington DC just a couple of weeks ago talking to diaspora, and you'd think that Kenyans in diaspora, you'd imagine are on the opposite spectrum of slums. You know, they've made it to the very pinnacle of global society. But my message to them was one, that all of us, and I mean all of us in this room, at least those of us who are Kenyans, regardless of where we were born, where we grew up, whether we were born in Iceland, as Ronald, who's now a major star from Sunday, told us he was born. He told the whole country, you grew up in Iceland. Whether you grew up in Iceland, or Huruma, or Mudaiga, or Mombasa, I grew up in Mombasa. There's one thing all of us as Kenyans internalized, that we are all third worlders. We were born in a third world country. We grew up in a third world country. And we have internalized the fact that we belong to the third world. And what does third world mean? What does it mean to be third world? We've used that term very liberally about ourselves over the years, and we continue to use it. And third world, I always ask the question, how many of you have ever been in a fourth class anything? Fourth class train, seat, fourth class bus, fourth class airplane, seat. How many of you have a fourth class, ever have a fourth class degree? Fourth class doesn't exist, right? The worst you can be is third class. So when we refer to ourselves as third world, what does it mean? And my message to your fellow Kenyans in the diaspora who are, you know, many of them are doing very well and have traveled and traversed the world, is that even sitting there in Washington, D.C., or in New York, they still have a third world, third class mentality. And even in Washington, D.C., they still look at themselves and have internalized the fact that they are third world people. So what does that mean? It means that when they're in Washington, D.C., or in New York, or in Europe, or wherever, those things are for those people. Right? The standards, the good infrastructure, the work ethic, the decent, you know, the order belongs to London, it belongs to Washington, D.C. And we're here, we understand it. But when we come back home, now we're home. We're back to the third world, where we belong, where things are done a certain way, right? Disorderly, low work ethic. If I make a promise to you to deliver something tomorrow morning and deliver to you the following morning, that's okay, right? You have roads engineers. All of us have roads engineers. We're all citizens of Nairobi, aren't we? Whether you're in Mudaiga or Islands, you have a Nairobi City Council with a mayor and a town clerk and a town engineer. And you pay your taxes, which goes to them. But it's okay to have a pothole or two. I mean, they're trying their best. We're all in a third world. And so, Vision 2030 is about getting out of that mentality. Pure and simple. So I'm not going to talk about the economic pillar, the social pillar, the political pillar. It's important that all of us understand what's in those pillars. Very important. And obviously in your in the program you have me there talking about the economic pillar and youth innovations, and that's important. The economic pillar, if I may, is about creating jobs. And creating jobs mostly for the young people in this country. From what I'm seeing, Slumcode, through SlumFest and your other activities, you are in the process of unshackling yourself from this third world, third class mentality. Tomorrow we're going to be officially opening Thika Road. Now, opening Thika Road is merely commissioning a piece of infrastructure. The big deal is not in the 8-lane highway. The big deal is in the mentality that accompanies that 8-lane highway. Because everybody in this room, people I meet, and I'm sure the people in Slumcode that you deal with, in Huruma or in Eastlands or whatever it is, these are brilliant people, hardworking people. I hope you're gonna have a wonderful evening. Unfortunately, I do have to leave. I would have wanted to join all, you know, the dinner and the festivities, and especially have Jean-Marc Julien, Exponential Potential. And because I dared to dream, I am a superstar in a video of a guy like Giuliani. Because I wasn't constrained. I was not constrained. I didn't believe that that place is for some people. I said, no, I'm going to be. And so if he's going to do an exponential potential, make sure that he, basically, he has to mention some of his superstars in that video. So I'm very sorry to not be able to be here. But I think this is a wonderful, wonderful idea. Congratulations on your sixth SlumFest. And from a Vision 2030 perspective, this is exactly what we want to see young people doing. Because Vision 2030, at the end of the day, the transformation we're talking about for this country is mostly about young people. It is mostly about young people. It's about saying, what kind of nation shall we have in the year 2030, and you will determine what that nation will be. I am very hopeful and I'm very sure it will be a great nation, and there will be no more third world mentality, or we can't go to Strathmore because we belong to the slums. Congratulations once again, and thank you very much.